Essex.
Mr. Speaker, before establishing official trade talks with China, issues with human, environmental and labour rights must be addressed. And despite the recent report on Canadian job loss due to existing trade with China, the Liberals seem keen on pushing through a deal. But once again, they are completely lacking transparency. First, the PM was going to China to talk trade. Then he wasn't. In China, he talked trade, but there was no deal. And then the last minute, his trade minister stays behind to work on a deal. What is going on? When will this government be clear with Canadians and reveal their China trade list of priorities?
The Honourable Minister. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Canada is a nation, a trading nation, and is trying to diversify its markets in order that our economy be able to create good jobs. We have a commitment to trying to find a trade agreement with China, but we'll do it in our interests and while respecting our values. The Honourable Member for Berthier-Masquinongé. Mr. Speaker, according to a report commissioned by Global Affairs Canada, we know that we have already lost 105,000 jobs because of trade with China. Now the government seems to be rushing full steam ahead to initiate talks on a free trade accord with China. Does the government have the least idea about the number of Canadian jobs that will be in danger with a free trade agreement with China? The Honourable Minister. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Canadians are aware that our trade success is extremely important and that things take time. Canadians also understand that we have to take the time to do things well. With 600 new good jobs created in 2 years and an unemployment rate under 6%, I think we're doing quite well.